Welcome to this 13th lecture on calculus of variations. In the last video, we have derived Ostrogradsky equation. This is a short video on an example of Ostrogradsky's equation. Let's see how we can use this equation. This was like analogous to Euler's equation when we have like functionals of the form f, x, y, z, zx, zy, dx, dy. When we have functionals of this form, then we have this Ostrogradsky's equation. Let's try to find an example. Let's try to solve a problem using this Ostrogradsky's equation, right? So we have this problem of surface of least area spanned by a given contour. So what does it mean? It means that suppose you have this a fixed region R in xy plane. This is your x-axis, this is your y-axis, and you have this fixed region R in xy plane, and you have this function z is equal to zxy. So this is basically a surface, right? So suppose and you are taking your xy from this region R, then corresponding to every point in this region R, you have a value z, and so you have something like this. You have this surface, right? Okay, you have this surface and you want to find out like what is this z should be, what this function should be, such that for a given region R the surface area is minimum, surface area of this thing is minimum. So you have to find out, you are given this region R in xy plane, and you have to find out the relation, this function z, such that the surface area of this part is minimum. Okay, let's try to do that. So basically we want to find out an integral which computes a surface area, this whole surface area, right? How can we compute that? For that, if I know a small elementary area here, suppose this is a small elementary area, then I know that this surface area will be integration of, I can integrate, like I can sum these small elementary areas, and then I can find the total surface area, right? So we want to find out an elementary surface area here on this surface, right? If you can project it on this xy plane. Okay, suppose this is your region R, you can project this surface, that elementary surface, on xy plane. So you have something like this. This is your elementary surface, okay, and this is your xy plane, and this elementary surface, this is the projection of elementary surface on xy plane, okay, fine. So what will be the relation between this elementary surface and this dx dy? We know that this small area dx dy in the xy plane, the elementary area in xy plane will be dx dy. So what is the relation? Relation is that this is a projection of this. So if theta is the angle between them, if I draw the a line across the surface, across this and one in here, then if theta is the angle between these two lines, then dx dy, this part, the small elementary area here, will be elementary area here times cos of the angle between these two surfaces, this elementary surface and this dx dy, right? Now we know that if you have like two lines, the angle between these two lines is same as angle between their normals, right? So instead of finding this angle theta, we can find a normal to this elementary surface and a normal to dx this xy plane, and we can compute the angle between those two normals, right? Now what is the normal to this elementary surface? So we know that if your surface is given by, what is your surface here? Your surface is z is equal to zxy. So basically the equation of your surface fxyz is z minus zxy. This is the equation of your surface, right? So, and we know that normal is in the direction of gradient of the function. So basically del f, del f is the, del f is your gradient of f, it is in the direction of normal. So what will be this? This will be del f is curly f by curly x I cap plus curly f by curly y j cap plus curly f by curly z k cap, where I, j and k are the unit vectors in the x direction, y direction and z direction, right? Fine. Where this I, this is the definition of gradient, right? And you should know that the normal is in the direction of gradient, right? So I have this given surface. So what will be the differentiation of this this function with respect to x, that is curly f by curly x, will be curly z by curly x, okay, with a negative sign. And then, so this is the component of the gradient in I direction, that is x direction. And then component of the gradient in y direction will be the differentiation of this function f with respect to y, that will be minus curly z by curly y. And then component of this gradient of this function in z direction will be curly f by curly z, that is your 1. So this is the normal, this is the normal direction of the normal to this elementary surface. And you already know what is normal to x-axis, that is k cap, okay? So, okay, I have used here ez cap. So basically I have used ex cap for I, ey cap for j and ez cap for k, right? So we know that cos of the angle will, if now you have two vectors, curly f, gradient of f and ez. This is normal to our elementary surface and this is normal to our xy plane. So how to compute the angle? Angle will be dot product of these two vectors divided by magnitude of the first vector times magnitude of the second vector. So this is like this, and we have computed this gradient. This is equal to this times dot product with ez cap. And what is the magnitude of this vector? Is minus zx square, that is x component square plus y component square plus z component square, times what is the magnitude of ez cap, that is a unit vector, so its magnitude is 1. Now you know how to take the dot product. Dot product will be, here is no component for ex cap, so that will be 0, second term will be 0, third term will be 1, divided by zx, 1 plus zx square plus zy square plus 1. Sorry, 1 plus zx square plus zy square, square root. So this is your cos of the angle. Now you have elementary area is equal to dx dy. Elementary area is equal to dx dy divided by cos theta. This is your elementary area, right? So required area is integration of elementary area, where integration will take place in this region R. So this is equal to dx dy divided by cos theta. Cos theta is 1 upon 1 square root of 1 plus z square, zx square plus zy square. So you will get integration, double integral over R of the function 1 plus zx square plus zy square dx dy, right? Okay, so where we reach? Okay, so we have this. This is our surface area. This is the given surface area. So basically, you have this R and you have a function z is equal to zxy. So you have a surface like this. This is a surface. So this is the area of this surface. And we want to find out this relation z such that this area is minimum, right? Now you can see that here z is a function of two variables. So we need to apply this Ostrogradsky's equation. This is your functional. Sorry, this is your functional and this is your f. So you now apply your Ostrogradsky's equation. So what you will get? You will get that this is Ostrogradsky's equation. Partial derivative of f with respect to z minus dy by dx of fzx minus dy by dy of fzy. Now what is the derivative of this function? Partial derivative of this function with respect to z, that is 0 because there is no explicit z, so it is 0. Minus dy by dx of partial derivative of this function with respect to zx, that will be 1 upon 2 times square root of 1 plus zx square plus zy square into chain rule 2 times zx, 2, 2 will cancel. Similarly, this is partial derivative with respect to y, right? Now you can further differentiate it with respect to x and differentiate it with respect to y. You will get something like this, okay? Now to make the notation simple, I'll use these notations. P for zx, q for zy, r for zxx, S for ZXY, T for ZYY. Okay, you will, if you will do some manipulation, you can do it. You will reach it, reach here. So this is your R 1 plus Q square minus 2PQ S plus T 1 plus P square is equal to 0. So this is a non-linear second order differential equation. Okay, and it's difficult to solve this differential equation, but we would physically like to know what this represents, what this differential equation represents. Okay, so let's see. So basically we know that if z is equal to zxy gives the minimum surface area, then this z has to satisfy this differential equation, right? So we would like to know what physically this differential equation represents. Okay, so for that you should know this: if your surface is given by this z is equal to zxy, then the mean curvature, curvature of a surface is a number, okay, which represents that how away is your surface from being flat. Okay, so if your surface is z is equal to zxy, then the mean curvature is given by this. This is from differential geometry. I'll not explain how this comes, but if you have this surface which is given by z is equal to zxy, then its mean curvature is given by this. Now you are saying that this zxy is corresponding to the surface, this function corresponds to the minimum surface area for a given contour if 1 plus p square times t minus 2 s p q plus 1 plus q square times t is equal to 0. In the last slide you have seen that this is the extremal only if this satisfies this differential equation. If this satisfies this differential equation, it means that its mean curvature is 0, because this is the formula for mean curvature. So it means that, and if the mean curvature of some surface is 0, we call that surface as minimal surfaces. Okay, so it means that the required surfaces here are the minimal surfaces. So it means, now you know that if you have a given contour and you have a surface generated by that contour, that is z is equal to zxy, where your xy belongs to this R, okay, this is your R, then this, the surface area will be least if this surface is the minimal surface. It means that it has mean curvature is equal to 0. Okay. Let's see one more example. For example, if you want to write, this is your functional. If you want to write the Ostrogradsky's equation for this functional, you have this f. F is a function of x, y, z, zx, zy, right? So your functional will be, Ostrogradsky's equation will give you fz minus curly by curly x of fzx minus curly by curly of fzy. So what is that? That is 0 minus curly by curly x of, differentiate it with respect to curly z by curly x, that will be 2 times curly z by curly x minus curly by curly y of, differentiation of this function with respect to zy, that will be minus 2 times curly z by curly y. So you will get curly 2z by curly x square plus curly 2z by curly y square is equal to 0. So this is a Laplace equation. There are like lots of techniques available for solving Laplace equation, and you can use those techniques. And now let's see how to write the Ostrogradsky's equation. I already told you that for the convenience we have taken that z is a function of x and y only. It may be possible that there are more than two independent variables. So for example, if you have a functional of the form x, y, z, these are your three independent variables, then u, then ux, then uy, then uz, then you have dx, dy, dz. You can have like this. Here also you can apply your Ostrogradsky's equation. So you can look at this example. This is, here you have u is your dependent function and x, y, z are your independent variables. So what will be the Ostrogradsky's equation in this case? That will be, for example, here we had fz, here we will have fu minus curly by curly x of fux minus curly by curly y of fuy minus curly by curly z of fuz is equal to 0. So now what is fu? Fu is, you can see, this is your f. So fu is differentiation of f with respect to u, that will be 2 times fxyz, right? Minus curly by curly x of derivative of f with respect to ux, so that will be 2 times curly u by curly x minus curly by curly y of differentiation of f with respect to uy, that will be 2 times curly u by curly y, similarly minus curly by curly z, 2 times curly u by curly z. So this is, you can simplify it, you get this, this is curly 2u by curly x2 plus curly 2u by curly y2 plus curly 2u by curly z2 is equal to fxyz. This is Poisson's equation, and there are again lots of techniques to solve this Poisson's equation. Okay, so this was Ostrogradsky's equation. Till now, what we are doing is, like, we had like fixed boundaries. For example, in Euler's equation, we had extreme values. We have find extreme. We have found the extreme values of functionals of the form this, where y was specified at the endpoints, right? So boundary was fixed. And in case of Ostrogradsky's equation, we had like over R, f x y z, z x z y, dx dy, and this function f was z was specified on the boundary of R, right? So we had till now fixed boundaries. In the coming videos, we will have this free boundaries. Okay. So we will next try to do the cases when we have free boundaries. Thank you.